having escaped the corruption. We're going to escape the corruption. I said we escaped the corruption. You know, everybody is crying. Even the sinners are crying. They're saying there's too much corruption in this country. Corruption in the office. Corruption in the school. Corruption of examination malpractice. Corruption almost everywhere. But every one of us saved by grace, sanctified by faith, filled with the Holy Ghost, as we walk our lives this year, any office, anywhere we find ourselves, we're going to escape that corruption in Jesus' name. But we'll not talk like them, or live like them, or steal like them, or embezzle like them, or be immoral like them, or be soiled by the dirt and the defilement of this world like them, saved and sanctified and set apart from the corruption that is in the world through laws. It is ours in Jesus' name. And this promise we're going to live in the enjoyment and the benefit of these better promises. We're looking at Hebrews chapter 6, a reading from verse 12. Hebrews chapter 6, verse 12. That ye be not slothful. Slothful in prayer? No. That ye be not slothful. Slothful in reading the Bible? No. That ye should not be slothful in morning devotion, family devotion? You'll not be slothful. That you'll not be slothful in soul winning? You'll not be slothful in the things, spiritual things the Lord is calling you to this year. That ye be not slothful, but followers of them who through faith and patience inherit the promises. Inherit the promises. Anybody going to inherit promises here this year? You will, you will, you will in Jesus' name. We're looking at Hebrews chapter 10 verse 19. Hebrews chapter 10 verse 19. Having therefore, brethren, boldness to enter into the holiest by the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus has been shed for us. And the blood of Jesus that was shed for us, that blood is to make us enter boldly, not timidly. Not as if maybe, I don't know whether the Lord will receive me or not, whether he will grant me the privilege or not, whether his face is going to shine upon me or not, but will come before the Lord. And it says we enter boldly into the holiest, into the holy of holies, by a new and living way, which he has consecrated for us through the veil, that is to say, his flesh. And having a high priest over the house of God, let us draw near with what kind of heart? A true heart. A true heart. Let's leave all the deception behind. Let's leave all the hypocrisy behind. Let's leave all the hide and seek of the past years. Let's leave all that there. Let's live a transparent life this year. A life that everybody can see through. A life that what you say is what you mean. What you mean is what you say. A life that in the private, in the public, is all the same. And then you're living in that glory of the Lord and that light of the gospel shining, shining out of your life with a true heart. And then it says in full assurance, not partial assurance, in full assurance. In fact, isn't that faith? Faith is F-A-I-T-H. What does that mean? Full assurance in a trusting hearts. That's how to live this year. You are trusting the Lord. And because you trust the Lord and you have confidence in the Lord with all your heart, all your soul, and all your mind, there is that full assurance in a trusting hearts. And then it says, having our hearts sprinkled from an evil conscience, our bodies washed with pure water. Let us hold fast the profession of our faith without wavering, for he is what? Faithful that promise. He has given us these great promises, and he's a faithful God, and because he is faithful, that's why we're trusting him with full assurance, following after the Lord. Verse 35, cast not away, therefore, your confidence, which has great reward of great recompense of reward. For ye have need of patience, that after ye have done the will of God, what will happen? Ye might receive the promise. After ye have done the will of God. This year, we commit this year to be the will of God. Will of God in everything. Young people, bachelors in particular, they're only thinking about will of God in marriage. Will of God, yes, in marriage, but his brother is greater than that. Will of God as you go to work. What I'm selling, is this the will of God to sell tobacco? No. Will of God, is this the will of God for me to sell alcohol? No. Will of God, is this the will of God for me to smoke marijuana? No. Will of God, is this the will of God for me to join business with unbelievers? He's serving the devil, I'm serving God. Is it the will of God for us to be together? No. The Lord is telling us that this year, after we have done the will of God, we're going to inherit the promises in Jesus' name. You wake up in the morning, your prayer is, our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy will be done on earth as it is where? Done in heaven. This year we're committing ourselves to doing the will of God in everything and every time and everywhere. And it says, after you have done the will of God, it's only then we're going to inherit the promises. You have inherited the promise in Jesus' name. For yet a little while, and he that shall come will come and will not tarry. Now the just shall live how? By faith. But if any man draw back, anybody going to backslide this year? Going to draw back this year? Not going to reveal that you are not found in your place this year? Anybody there? No. It says, if any man draw back, my soul shall have no pleasure in him. But we are not of them who draw back unto perdition. I will not draw back. I said I will not draw back. We are not of them that draw back unto perdition, but of them that believe to the saving of the soul. 2 Corinthians chapter 7 verse 1. We have the better promises. What's to be our response? Since we have the better promises, the greater promises, what should be your response? The Lord has favored you, and he says, I'm lifting you higher, I'm moving you forward, I'm giving you promises that are better than any promise of those Old Testament people, patriarchs or prophets. Let's look at 2 Corinthians chapter 7 verse 1. Having therefore these promises, dearly beloved, let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness. Out of gratitude to God, out of appreciation of the better promises the Lord has given us, the promise to save, the promise to heal, the promise to strengthen, the promise to supply, the promise to sanctify, the promise to saturate us with the Holy Ghost, and the promise to answer all our prayers, the promise that you decree, see, and shall be established. Having all these great promises, dearly beloved, in appreciation of what the Lord has promised that is going to do for us, in us and through us this year, let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh and of the spirit, perfecting holiness in the fear of God. We'll do that in Jesus' name. I come to point number 2, and it is blameless purity and renewed consecration. Blameless purity and renewed consecration. You know, the Lord wants our lives to be above reproach. That is, when you look at your own self, your conscience will not reproach you. Your conscience will say, but you say you're a Christian. But we live a blameless life. That your conscience will say, praise the Lord, this year things are much better than previous years. That your mind will not reproach you. You'll be able to say, praise the Lord, is giving you victory in the private and in the public. That your mind will affirm the very fact that
you have been blessed with this powerful message. Our address is at the bottom of the screen. I believe you will join us one of this Sunday to worship together. Thank you. God bless you. Let us pray. Our mighty Father, we glorify your name and thank you, Lord, because of this powerful message. I pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, you will touch those people who are in need of salvation, those people who are in need of prosperity, those people who are in need of healing. And by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, they will give testimony because of this message. In Jesus' name we pray.
Say it one more time, say, oh, oh, oh.